Hello, welcome to this video. It's Leonard here from GuitarLeonard.com, and in today's video we are actually going to look at the difference between futures trading and perpetual swap. Now when it comes to derivative trading with cryptocurrency, this is common with every other exchange, and it has been around since 2014 when it started gaining attention with the exchanges and so on. And right now it is something that is very common among crypto trading exchange. So we'll talk about derivative trading. Under derivative, you see futures, you see perpetual swap, you see options, and then some other gaming system or platform that, you know, some exchanges integrate to their own platform. So we are going to look at specifically in this video the difference between perpetual swap and then futures, which is the most common actually. Now the both of them are part of a type of trading which is derivative. You know, when you trade with a very high amount, you are trading leverage actually with this, with little amount of money in your account. You can trade 1 Bitcoin, you can trade 2 Bitcoin, you can trade 3 Bitcoin, even when you don't have the money that is equivalent to that 3-5 Bitcoin that you'll be trading. So we are going to actually look at that in this video, and then you get a better understanding of it, so that when you come in to trade, you can decide to go with futures or with perpetual swap. It all depends on what you actually want for yourself. So to explain this, I'm actually using the OKX platform. This is common with every other exchange that you see out there actually. But the basic thing is to get the understanding of what this is. Now the futures, both futures and perpetual swap work the same way. You make money in both ways, whether the price is going up or down. The most important thing is that your predictions are right. If you predict that Bitcoin price is going down and it goes in your favor, you are making money in both perpetual swap and in futures trading. And if you predict that the price of Bitcoin or any crypto asset that you want to trade is actually going up and it goes in your favor, in both perpetual swap and futures, you make money both ways. So there is both long and short option in both perpetual and futures trading. So when you buy, you are going long in both futures and perpetual, and then when you sell, you are going short in both futures and perpetual. So every other thing here is the same. The trading orders, the different types of orders, all of them are the same. The only different between these two is that why futures trading actually have expiring date, perpetual swap, as the name implies, or perpetual futures don't have expiring date. So if you have an open trade here, that means that trade will continue to be open for as long as you want it and so on, without a expiring date on them. That is what makes perpetual swap different from, that is one of the difference between perpetual swap and futures. Futures have expiring date. Please get that right. Futures have expiring date and perpetual swap don't have expiring date. Futures can expire in a week, it can expire in a month, it can expire quarterly or yearly. It all depends on the options you are going with. So that you will note whenever you go to your exchange and you want to trade, you can always see like the pair that I'm trading currently now is BTC USDT perpetual. You see the perpetual attached to it. If it is futures, for instance, that I want to trade, when you see here that it is BTC USDT, you see some numbers attached to it, and that number represent, which I will show you in a moment, represent the expiring date of that particular asset that you want to trade at that point in time. So the major difference there is, one, perpetual swap don't have expiring date, but futures have expiring date. It could be weekly, it could be monthly, or it could be quarterly, and so on. And another difference is that why there is a funding fee, as you can see here, we are on the perpetual tab, and here you see there is a countdown of time here that says time to funding. Right now, across all exchange, there is a funding fee that is calculated every 8 hours. So whatever exchange you are trading, and if you are trading perpetual swap, it means that every 8 hours there is a fee that you pay to keep your position open. And in this case, the way these fees are calculated is that if you are a short position holder, and let me, right now that this is actually showing, the current rate is showing minus 0.006% or thereabout, it means as a short position holder, I'll be paying a certain fee to long position holder. So if there is anybody in the market there that is actually holding a long position. And on my dashboard here, since I'm holding a short position, it means that when this time is calculated, at the end of this time, this fee that is going to be deducted on my account will be paid to those who are holding long positions. So short position holders, when it is minus, it means that right now the spot price of this particular asset is a little bit greater than the current price at which you are trading it at the perpetual swap. So you pay fee to long position holders. And the other way around, if you are holding a long position, means that short position holders will be paying fee to you. And this is calculated every 8 hours. It is across all exchanges. That is what keeps your position open since it doesn't have expiring date. Whereas on the other hand, let's go here. If I go back here to the coin tab and say want to trade BTC, and then on the OKX platform, when I type in the asset that I want to trade, you see spot, you see simple option trading, and then you see margin trading. So under the margin trading, you see perpetual swap, and then you see features. So if I click on features, you will see that there are BTC, USD has expiring date. This will expire like on the 6th of August. That is what it is. The month comes before the date. And then this will expire on the 13th of August. This will expire on the 24th of September. This will expire on the 31st of December. So in some of other platform, in some exchanges, what you see here is quarterly, you see weekly expiration. Even if I open this on my phone, if I open the OKX platform on my phone, you see beneath it, it will tell you that this is monthly, this will expire in a month, this will expire in a week, or this will expire in 3 months, and so on. So whatever options you see here, you go ahead and select it. Let's say I want to trade this, and I go ahead and select that. You see here BTC USD with the expiring day, which is 6th of August, and today is 5th. We are making this video 5th. So here, instead of the time to fund, it is showing you time to deliver. Time to deliver, because it is 6th of August, it is just a day from the time of making this video. So if I go back again and then search for BTC again, and then I scroll down here and go to features, and let's say we want to go with the one that will expire September or thereabout. So I'll go ahead and select that. This time around, under the features, instead of seeing time to deliver, time funding time, you are going to see time to deliver, which is in this case 50 days from the time of making this video, because this will expire on the 24th of September. So basically, these are the major difference between perpetual swap and features trading with any exchange you are going to actually trade with. So to assess these, what are features of perpetual swap, you come in here, you type in the asset you want to trade, and when you type that, you scroll down here to where it says margin trading on the OKX platform, and then under the margin trading, you see where it says perpetual and features. So you just go ahead and select whatever option that suits you best, whether it's perpetual or features, you go ahead and select that. And once you select that, you can now go ahead and carry out your trade. Don't worry about the funding fee for perpetual. I prefer trading perpetual personally, so don't worry about the funding fee. It is not that much. So everything is calculated at the end of the trade. Everything is settled automatically. So it is not something you need to bother about whether you can afford it or not. Yes, you can afford it. Your profit, if you are in profit, your profit covers for all of those in every trade. So that is basically what perpetual swaps are, and then what futures trading is. So futures trading has expiring date, and then perpetual swaps don't have expiring date. Why you pay a funding fee to keep your position open with perpetual swap? You don't pay those fee to keep any position open with features. So with the OKX platform, to have access to either features or perpetual swap, first you over trade, you go to margin trading, and then when you come in here to select the asset, you type in your asset. Once you type in the asset you want to trade, you see this different option under the margin trading. So you see perpetual and then you see features. So you go ahead and select whatever you prefer, and you go ahead and carry out the trade. So basically, that is it. That is what I wanted to show you in this video, and I hope you understand it. If you don't get it clearly, you can always use the comment section, and I will leave a detailed write-up about perpetual and futures equally in the video description. So I'll see you in the next video.